Hello everyone, I am Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to this series called Finance Current Affairs. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try and discuss them with the help of different questions. So before moving on to question number one, if you are there for the very first time, you can subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all latest updates. You can also join our Telegram group. The free PDFs of these sessions will be available on that very group. Now, talking about the first question, instead of discussing the questions first and then the concept, this session is going to be dedicated to a special topic, that is the bi-monthly monetary policy statement. So as you all know, recently this statement has been released. So we'll discuss the entire statement first and then we'll come to the questions related to that. So moving on to the monetary policy statement then. So for the month of October 2021, the statement has been released after a three-day meeting of the Monetary Policy Committee. Talking about this statement, what has been these policy stance, what decisions have been taken. So talking about that, RBI has kept the rates unchanged for the eighth time in a row. So it has continued with its accommodative stance. Talking about the accommodative stance, so they will continue to keep the interest rates low, they will continue to inject the liquidity in the economy to make sure that the economy recovers and sees a good growth comes back on a good growth trajectory. So this is the eighth time that this accommodative stance has been maintained, and this is going to continue till the recovery is durable. So they have decided to continue it as long as it's necessary to revive and sustain the growth on a durable basis. Talking about it further, what has been the rationale behind this very decision? So although inflation was there, but now it is within the limits, so there's no need to increase the rates. But they have also not reduced the rates or changed their stance because they want to still inject some liquidity in the economy, still they want the economy to recover. So the MPC noted that the economic activity has broadly evolved over a certain time period, but still there is some inflation, although lower than the earlier level, but it's not that high that we need to increase the interest rates. Moreover, the demand is improving, and this improving is still not that very high. The output level is still below the pre-pandemic levels, so we still need to go a long way to improve and get back on the growth rate which we had prior to the pandemic. So the recovery still remains uneven and dependent upon the continuous policy support. So still there is a need of government support, the policy support. Abhi bhi zarurat hai ki central bank aisi policies ke saath aaye jo economy ko recover karne mein aur growth lane mein help kare. So that's why this decision has been taken by the Monetary Policy Committee, and they are willing to continue with this stance as long as it's necessary to help economy recover back and come back on the growth track which it had prior to the pandemic. So contact intensive sectors are still lagging. That's why these decisions have been taken by the Monetary Policy Committee. So what are these decisions? Let's have a look at that. So talking about the policy rates, as stated, these rates are unchanged. Koi bhi change nahi hua hai policy rates mein aur reserve ratios mein. So what are these rates? Policy repo rate is 4%. That is the rate at which the banks can borrow from RBI. Then the rate at which the RBI can borrow from bank, the bank will lend them, is the reverse repo, which is 3.35%, the same as earlier. Marginal standing facility, wherein you as a bank can borrow from RBI in case of emergency. When the interbank market dries up, then the rate is 4.25%, and the bank rate, wherein the banks can borrow from RBI for long term, is 4.25%. Similarly, talking about the reserve ratios, they are also unchanged. The cash reserves ratio is 4% and SLR is 18%. So banks need to keep certain amount in the form of cash and certain in the form of the other liquid assets. So these decisions have been taken keeping in mind that we want growth and we want to make sure that the inflation stays within the tolerable band, 4% plus minus 2%. So 2 se 6% ke beech hi inflation rahe, in sab cheezon ko dhyan mein rakhte hue, growth ko dhyan mein rakhte hue, ye decisions liye gaye hain. Moving ahead now, to a very important thing, that is GSAP. We all know that the RBI was conducting the GSAP program, but now it believes that there is enough liquidity in the economy and remaining can be handled using the open market operations and the operation twist. So it has decided that it will now shut down the GSAP program. Abhi ke liye GSAP band kar diya gaya hai, and ye kyun kiya gaya hai? Kyunki already excess liquidity hai, government ki spending bhi ho rahi hai liquidity ki wajah se, and now there is no need for this. Although jahan bhi liquidity issues aayenge, us problem ko solve karne ke liye open market operations and operation twist are there. So talking about the open market operations, what are these? Basically buying and selling of the government securities to handle the liquidity in the economy, that is open market operations. Talking about the operation twist, so it's when the central bank uses the proceeds from the sale of short-term securities to buy long-term government debt papers. So short-term securities ke sale se jo paisa aata hai, usse long-term debt रेस करना ताकि इंटरेस्ट रेट्स लॉन्ग रन में ईज हो जाए, दैट्स द वेरी ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द ऑपरेशन ट्विस्ट. सो GSAP अभी के लिए होल्ड कर दिया गया है. Moving ahead now, along with the monetary policy statement comes up the statement on the development and regulatory policies. So there are different developmental and regulatory decisions which are taken as far as this statement is concerned. So kis kis area mein decisions liye gaye hain, kya major development and regulatory policy changes laye gaye hain, let's discuss that. So four major areas hain jisse related kuch measures aaye hain. First is the liquidity measures. Okay, some set of measures have been taken for the payment and settlement systems as well. Payment and settlement systems ko aur enhance karne ke liye kuch measures liye gaye hain. Debt management ka kuch decision liya gaya hai, and financial inclusion aur customer protection increase karne ke liye kuch decisions liye gaye hain. So let's discuss them one by one. Moving to the liquidity measures first. So liquidity enhance karne ke liye kya decisions liye hain? Although GSAP has been put up on a hold, that program has been shut down as of now, but still some liquidity measures are taken, like the ones for the small finance banks. Small finance banks provide a lot of support to the economy. They are helping out the small businesses, the MSMEs, and providing them these funding, the support. So what decision RBI took? RBI came up with a special 3-year long-term operation that was there in the month of May. So May mein RBI ne special long-term operation shuru kiye the, within which what happened was that the banks can, the small finance banks can borrow from RBI for a 3-year time period under the, as per the repo rates. Okay, so 10,000 crore ka amount tha jo allocate kiya gaya tha. That was available till 31st October, and now they have extended it till 31st December. Kyunki small finance banks itna support kar rahe hain, there is a need to support these small finance banks also, so that they further help the small business units, MSMEs, other unorganized sectors which are suffering because of the pandemic. So that's why this extended facility has been provided. This is the liquidity measure taken. So ye decision kyun liya gaya, these are the reasons explaining the same. Moving ahead now with to the payment and settlement systems, isse related kya measures liye gaye hain, let's discuss that. So first is introducing the digital payment solutions in the offline mode. RBI pehle se hi try kar raha tha ki jo log internet फैसिलिटी अवेल नहीं कर पाते, ऐसे अनबैंक्ड एरियाज़ में है, वहाँ पे कुछ ऐसा प्रोवाइड किया जाए कि डिजिटल पेमेंट्स तो हो सके, बट देर इज़ नो नीड फॉर इंटरनेट. सो दे आर बी आई इज़ गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड अ फ्रेमवर्क ऑन द सेम, विच विल बेसिकली प्रोवाइड न्यू अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ फॉर द इंडिविजुअल्स, फॉर द बिजनेसेस टू गो फॉर डिजिटल पेमेंट्स विदाउट द नीड फॉर इंटरनेट. सो अ स्कीम टू टेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज़ विच विल इनेबल द डिजिटल पेमेंट्स इवन इन द रिमोट एरियाज was something which was announced earlier in August. Okay, so given the encouraging experience gained from the pilot test, isse related tests conduct kiye gaye ki kaise digital payments avail karai jayengi logo ko without the need of internet, and now RBI is going to come up with the framework regarding the same. So it has proposed to introduce a framework for retail digital payments in the offline mode across the country. This will expand the reach of digital payments and open up new opportunities for the individuals and for the businesses. So this obviously, when digital payments will be available, it will provide new opportunities for the ones who are using it. Moving ahead now to the next decision taken regard to the payment and settlement systems. So they are going to enhance the limit of IMPS. IMPS, that is the immediate payment services of which were introduced by the NPCI, they allow 24/7 domestic funds transfer facility. You can go for internet banking, mobile banking, bank branches can be used, ATMs can be used for the payment systems, for the basically payment purposes. So there was a limit earlier. 2 lakh was the limit per transactions through IMPS other than through SMS or IVRS. Okay, so integrated voice response system, SMS, they use your computer technology using the SMS, using the voice message, using the voice communication, you can basically do the payments transactions. So there was a limit on other than these kinds of transactions of 2 lakh for other IMPS transactions except through SMS and IVRS. SMS and IVRS ke liye transaction limit 5,000. It's small for that. But for other transactions which you are doing using IMPS, 2 lakh per transaction is the limit. And RBI has now decided to increase it to rupees 5 lakhs. So this is another decision that has been taken. And in the view of the importance of the IMPS in processing of domestic payment transactions, this decision has been taken. So talking about it further, this will provide an additional facility to customers to make digital payments beyond 2 lakhs. So, those usse zyada ka transaction jo IMPS ke through karna chahte the, wo nahi kar pate the, now they can do so. Moving ahead to the next decision taken under the payment and settlement measures, it is geotagging of the payment system touch points. So there are certain areas where the payment systems are not operating that well, there are not that good infrastructure for payment and settlement system. So it would be so easy if we can track that which areas have the access to good payment infrastructures and which don't. If that is possible, then to those regions, those unbanked regions or those regions where we are not able to provide good infrastructure, we can improve on those areas. So geotagging is going to solve that problem. इससे पता लग जाएगा कि कहाँ पे पेमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर्स अच्छे यूज हो रहे हैं, कहाँ नहीं यूज हो रहे, कहाँ इंप्रूवमेंट की नीड है, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू कैन प्रोवाइड द सर्विस दीज काइंड्स ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन दोज एरियाज वेयर इट इज नॉट अवेलेबल. सो टू डीपन द डिजिटल पेनिट्रेशन अक्रॉस द कंट्री इज द प्रायोरिटी फॉर द फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन. ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों तक फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज पहुंच पाए इज द मेजर ऑब्जेक्टिव, एंड डिजिटल पेमेंट्स बेसिकली हेल्प अ लॉट इन दैट. सो वी नीड टू फोकस मोर ऑन डिजिटल पेमेंट्स टू इंश्योर द स्प्रेड ऑफ द spread of acceptance infrastructure across the country. It's necessary to ascertain the location information of existing payment acceptance infrastructure. कौन कौन से ऐसे merchants हैं जो अलग अलग payment infrastructures use कर रहे हैं, उसकी अगर हम location track कर पाएं तो easy हो जाएगा हमें वहाँ जहाँ वो services या वो infrastructure नहीं है वहाँ वो provide कराना. This will be possible through geotagging. In this regard, geotagging technology by providing location information on ongoing basis can help can be useful in targeting the areas where we have deficient infrastructure. So what RBI has proposed? It has proposed a framework for geotagging, जिससे आप geographical locations को capture कर सकते हो और ये ascertain कर पाओगे. You can ascertain whether the merchants are accepting the payment infrastructure like point of sale terminals, QR systems or not. This will ensure better deployment of the infrastructure, acceptance infrastructure, and it will provide more wider access to the digital payments. Moving ahead to the next decision in this regard, that's related to regulatory sandbox. So we have already discussed this in detail in one of the sessions. So according to that, 6 entities have cleared the first cohort. First cohort was on retail payments. Regulatory sandbox is basically when you do the live testing of innovative products before launching them in the market on a larger scale. So there are different cohorts based on different themes on which the testing is done. You are invited to come up with applications where you are introducing new products and services which will help in rendering the financial services in a better manner. So 6 entities cleared the first cohort. Second cohort, 8 entities were undergoing the test. Third cohort is open for applications. So, जो भी MSME lending से related नए product services के साथ आना चाहता है, वो applications fill कर सकते हैं. अब RBI ने क्या किया है? Fourth cohort की भी theme introduce कर दी है. RBI has come up with the theme for the fourth cohort, and it is preventing the prevention and the mitigation of financial fraud. So financial frauds ke sath hame kaise deal karna hai usse related ab aapko naye products and services ke sath aana hai. The application window has still not been opened, it will be opened in the due course. So what's the focus area? That the focus area is how we will be using the technology to reduce the lag between occurrence and detection of fraud. Koi fraud hota hai usko detect karne mein kafi time jata hai and problem resolve karne mein aur time jata hai. So kaise wo time minimize kare, fraud related cheezon mein kaise governance improve करें, how to strengthen the governance, how to minimize the response time to fraud is basically the objective of this cohort, and you have to come up with new services or products related to solving this problem. Other than that, for those cohorts which were already closed, the window has been opened again and the applications will once again be accepted. So this is what is written over here, on tap application of the earlier schemes. Moving ahead to the debt management measures now. So under the ways and means advances, the support is provided to the government. Okay, the state, central government can get the support from RBI. So this support was, the limit was enhanced, and now the date for that availability has further been extended. So to help the states to manage their cash flows amid the pandemic, it has been decided to continue with enhanced WMA limits of 51,560 crores. So is facility ko 6 mahine aur tak bada diya gaya hai. Other than that, if you are taking the overdraft facility, borrowing from the RBI, then the time period for overdraft facility has also been extended. Kitne din ke liye aap overdraft facility le sakte ho, for how long you can take the overdraft facility. Moving ahead to the last set of measures that relate to the financial inclusion and customer protection. Kaise hum zyada se zyada logo tak financial services pahunchaye aur kaise customers protected rahenge, usse related kuch measures aaye hain. First is priority related to priority sector lending. So NBFCs help a lot to serve the unserved, underserved sections of the society, providing them with the financial services, because of which a decision was taken that if the banks are lending to the NBFCs and NBFCs are further lending that amount to for agriculture purposes, for MSMEs, for housing purposes, then that will be classified under the priority sector lending, and those banks can basically take the benefit that is there available as far as the priority sector lending is concerned. This facility was available till 30th September, has now been extended till March next year. So NBFCs ko jo aap loan dete ho, jo wo further MSME, agriculture, housing ko dete hain, us loans ko aap priority sector lending mein mention kar sakte ho, iski jo timeline hai wo aur bada di gayi hai. Moving ahead now to the internal ombudsman for NBFCs. Ye customer protection ke liye step liya gaya hai. This step is to make sure more better customer protection. So what it has to say? The increased strength and reach of NBFCs has necessitated measures by RBI to protect the customers. Obviously, banks are being regulated under the ombudsman scheme where the customer grievances are actually handled. Now, NBFCs have to follow a framework similar to banks and other non-bank systems, according to which they have to appoint an internal ombudsman. So what that internal ombudsman will be doing, they will be examining the customer complaints which are in nature of deficiency in service and are wholly rejected by NBFCs. So customers NBFCs ko kuch complaints karte hain related to the service which they are availing. Ab wo complaints agar NBFC reject kar deta hai, then this internal ombudsman will be dealing with that, and they will have be handling the complaints related to any kind of deficiency in financial services being rendered. So this is a step taken to ensure more better customer protection. These are all the steps which have been taken in the current monetary policy and statement, this very statement where more regulatory and development things have been, measures have been taken. Moving ahead now to the questions. So four questions are there related to the monetary policy statement and this statement on the regulatory and the development measures taken. The first question says that RBI recently released the monetary policy statement after the monetary policy committee meeting of October 2021. Which of the following correctly states the policy rates? So we know the rates are unchanged and they are repo rate 4%, reverse repo 3.35, MSF 4.25, bank rate 4.25. So answer is option C. Moving to second question now. IMPS of that's immediate payment service of NPCI is an important payment system providing 24/7 instant domestic fund transfer facility and is accessible through various channels like internet banking, mobile banking apps, bank branches, SMS and all. what's the per transaction limit for the same other than for SMS and IVRS? So it was 2 lakhs earlier. Okay, earlier it was 2 lakhs. Now it has been increased to 5 lakhs. So answer is option C. Moving to third question now. Which of the following correctly states the theme of the regulatory sandbox fourth cohort? So fourth cohort ki theme kya hai? Prevention and the mitigation of financial fraud. So basically ye financial fraud se kaise hum unhe mitigate kar sakte hain, kaise jaldi se jaldi decision le sakte hain, usme deal karega. Coming to the last question now, RBI has introduced various development and regulatory policy measures relating to which of the following in the latest statement on development and regulatory policies. So, char type ke decisions liye gaye hain. We already know the liquidity measures have been taken, the measures under the payment and settlement systems, debt management, financial inclusion. In sabse related, humne already discuss kiya ki kya kya measures liye gaye hain. All four have been the policy measure areas. So, answer is option E. This was all for today's session. This is the key to the answers. With this, I would like to end up the session. Thank you so much.